LNG, you can knock them away. You can make them attack each other.
BLG マジレッドしか選択肢。
So that's why BLG taking away the Sivir and what she can look to provide in terms of the ulti being there. And for LNG trying to
push Aphelios Renata.
Topside. So I'm curious to see Noctan
Kennen. LNG はプレーオフに向けてマジでこのウーコン Noctan Kennen 準備してきたんだろうな。ただ新ジャオにレナータは結構これ Noctan のカウンター要素抜群にあるんで。いいピックだね。レナータ信者でオールイン構成に対してめっちゃ強い。相手のバックラインを崩壊させるチャンピオン一体獲得。南行く。
I will say now, LNG look very indexed into trying to
win something
fast. Like they have a lot of burst damage, but not a lot beyond that. There'll always be opportunities.
なるほど。レナータと信者をでアフリオス守って、もう好きに動いてもらう構成だ。Because the individual one from Mole draft, we're gonna have to be able to make it through some of the early dives that
swell they at least have. The pros want to reach T1-9. You know, it's been so long.Since BLG made it, Mazel, you're saying 2019, the roster was so different at that point. That was when we still had ADD, Kuro in the mid lane, Meteor was, you know, like coming up as the flagship player. Now looking completely different. And heck, BLG have gone through so many different iterations of rosters since that time. Heck, when Fofo was on the roster, going further back when we like King and
finally having one that they settled with that has struggled. But sadly, ショートトレードで勝ちゃいいのか。ジンジャオのレベル2ガンクケアして。
But I think in this series, we've seen them have to adapt from that and try to attack the map as a whole because of Tarzan's activity.
And even just Light and Lumao able to defend those 2v2 so far in this game. Game 1, BLG tried to find that advantage bot, but not...
Oh, Bean-san, よくそこに入れたね。
You can see Weiwei now, pathing down towards that bot side. Set them up for success, or at least get the pressure off of them because you know Light and Lumao, again, once they get those levels, are going to look for those aggressive trades. So we can see Tarzan actually making his way up towards his top side. You have mixed damage, so it does make it pretty nice with these ganks coming through. Going to be hard for Bin to itemize against ganks as the game progresses, but also having the CC available with the cannon.
And something else from game one, right, that we saw so crucial was Tarzan's willingness to commit to plays, but that level 6 mark for Doombie, right? The paranoia to join into the Rift Herald fight, those things are so important to keep an eye on in terms of the first moves for LNG, because you said they want to win fast, they want to win hard here in this third game.
And for LNG, at least, having the tools to do so, having the tools to do fine in these laning phases, we already can just see whenever Bin comes with the Counter-Strike, Allah can pop that E, get out of there. We're going to wait to see what Tarzan is able to do. Because he's already looking to come for this gank on top. He's gonna use the clone to be able to get over the wall and have a bit of a surprise angle.
Mental gameplay.
Oh, look, Mazel, Doombie's coming too.
And Bin is already sub 200 health. This is an easy slam dunk if Tarzan can navigate it. And Bin just needs to try to get out with the flash. He has the Counter-Strike. Tarzan waiting. It's not enough damage. Doombie was even up here just in case. Because they might look for a dive. He's a little bit zealous. They're gonna try to keep...
入れると思うなよ。
耐
えれると思うなよ。わ
あ。
アレさん、これきつい。レッドバフが。ウーコン E Q を我慢してればな。いや、あれからするともうあれ、フラッシュ切ってでも押しに行かないと、もうレン苦しくなる。
This is good. This is good because we are not biased, but I predicted LNG 3-1. And if I could be right on predictions, that would be nice.
You just
want to
take me and Dag this crown away from Blast Split, all right? I'm holding it dear, near and dear, all right? It's in my closet, ready to go. I'm not giving it to you, Lyric.
Well, Weiwei might have something to say about that because he's looking for this aggression. But no, Tarzan actually managing to get it.
Nice little gameplay mode, Tarzan. I will say some of the mental chips given back over to BLG because of this top lane play. He's calm, cool, and collected the whole time.
Yeah, and again, just look at where like the waves are at. Kennen's dealing with minions. These guys are still dealing with minions. Not able to get it through.
ギリギリ E のマナが。ギリギリ E のマナが帰ってきた。マナなかったのに。ダイブする瞬間に E のマナが帰ってきた。
How on the Akali, separate from the Ahri in game number one, does Icon kind of dissuade some of these paranoia plays from doing this?
I actually think it's a little bit easier for him individually in this matchup. Not quite sure how the specific matchup goes itself. Maybe we phone a friend, call Invedius on this one. Nocturne usually has a decent time into melee champions. You can, you know, get some good trades out, use that Q, but still not a ton of kill pressure coming out for Nocturne against an Akali. An Akali also using energy can just keep looking for those 5-point strikes. At level 6, I don't think Nocturne has the ability to paranoia onto the Akali and kill her because you could always just throw down your shroud. You have the E to be able to escape as well. So as long as he can kind of keep up heavy trades in mid lane, make it hard for Duin B to look to leave, I feel like Icon doing his job pretty fine. And he's even hitting level 6 first.
Yeah, and diving into that a little bit more though, it was game 1 reminiscing, right? That Rift Herald play, the early proactivity from Duin B with those paranoia. So it's about Icon trying to keep that pressure on. Speaking of pressure, the BLG again for the third game in a row.
このゲーム3ゲーム目にして BLG が初めて主導権を取りましたね。やっぱアフェリオス選択したのが効いてますね。あのガンクセットアップができるんで、グラビタム持ってる間にレーンの主導権が取れちゃうっていう世界ね。ちなみに対してプレッシャーがかけれて
る。
これ相当怖いはずですよ。バンクセットアップで。あかりがノクターンに対して勝ってるから。
Tarzan is making his way down because you can see pings coming through. They know that BLG are going to be looking for an invade. I feel like LNG's chance is locking down one member.
They don't know.
Weiwei
had no idea. He didn't hit the wind becomes lightning on a Tarzan. That's an easy turnaround. The capitalization and light gets the kill.
Great read coming out from LNG. They know the invade wants to come through. You said BLG not
really. ウコンがトップガンクで潰れたんで、そこスノーボールしようっていう考えだったんだけど、読んでましたね。
Setting up for them to disperse down Weiwei and to make sure they get a kill on their side.
It just felt like there wasn't respect paid to the fact that paranoia was available, right? Like, you're literally in the jungle right under Duin B, and I know it wasn't a huge factor in that one, but it was more so that the heads-up gameplay from LNG that we've seen consistent in this entire series so far.
And you can see why BLG are confident, right? Because they do have push in mid. They're committing Crisp down to this play. But you see Doggo start to walk back. Beautiful bubble from Lumao is really what seals the deal. The paranoia there is an insurance policy. I like how Duin B decides to follow it through anyway. And that gives them that. But BLG, still the team that I feel like do have a bit of rotated their bot lane up first. They should be able to get this. And LNG at this point, I feel like you just commit to sending your bot lane down to bot side, getting some camps. And hopefully for Tarzan, pathing down and starting to reclaim some of this vision in bot side river.
And this is the best setup we've seen from BLG around Rift Herald.
Rotation で負けてるから取れない。
Contest has been fighting skirmishes around that first Rift Herald or the second, and it really hasn't gone their way. But this time they have the right.
ボットレーンマジずっとガンクとだいぶプレッシャー感じてるだろうな。
A step in the right direction for BLG in terms of decision making around the map, which I feel like LNG have had the.
ミッドの主導権回復しないと。LNG。
Job to find a steady pace, and let's remember a lot of the advantages LNG built on were
今リコールが見えたんで一気にワード壊せますね。
When you're guessing where the Herald should be coming through, I'd guess it'd probably go down towards that bot side. Mm-hmm. Doggo is going to be your big team fight carry later on. I don't feel like we see Heralds used all too often for top, but it is an option because you will be able to win out in terms of the 1v1s insides later on with the Jax.
Midbot pressure 継続か。
Of LNG committing two side laners against one, right? Because mm-hmm. that paranoia will still be valuable.
So I see, level
いやあ、ドゥインビーさん、それまずいっすね。連きついんだろうな、涙積んでる。コントロールワードがないから、ドゥインビー。1戦目はつまなかったんです。
You'll be so upset. Yeah. As you know what? I'm gonna stop doing whatever I was just doing there because BLG.
You're coming up with some big letter words, side. All right? So it's a big high point words there, Lyric. I like it. I like it. It is Light and Lumao realizing they were getting collapsed on. We'll back out of that one. It's a little bit of a lull here, but both junglers hovering around this middle lane.
It looks like they're gonna go in for it. Icon has the Eon doing B.
The damage back and forth. It's like literally just watching dude be an icon. Do they go in? If so, Tarzan Weiwei go right in afterwards.
I feel like BLG are the ones who are more confident in terms
of. Yeah, 壊しに行けねえな。
Why Icon was the one going for those aggressive trades. And we could see Doombie even bought an early tier. I don't expect him to upgrade that or turn that into anything. But we're just buying it for the mana in lane to be able to contend with the push and contend with some of the trades that Icon has been putting through.
Well, both junglers just.
忍者が映ったんで壊せます。あー、なんとかボット回復しようとしてますね。
With the lanes coming through, they did try top.
Okay, well, I caster cursed them. Weiwei almost goes down here. Icon, he does use the perfect execution, get out of harm's way. Ala is on the flank. He wants it. He knows he can get it. No, he misses. And now he's found himself way.
Q が当たってれば。
Light comes through just at the last time.
このミスが連発するね。
Aggression coming through. You were saying we aren't seeing enough of it from LNG. They try to set up the play, and I feel like BLG have done a really good job at not allowing these openings to come through.
Patch として結構完璧だったんだけど。
Lock down and punish. We saw them trying to go into Nakali. She's easily able to escape.
スキルショットで。
Having his own tools to be able to protect himself as well. They both managed to get out of there and leaving Bin up in top lane to just collect a ton of these turret plates.Across the board, right? No turret plates over for Ala on the opposing side. Not a whole lot of turret plates going to anyone on the side of LNG as Cyclone does come through. They try to go instantly onto Xinjiao. I feel like Doombi could have maybe held his ult a little bit longer. You get some damage first, and then once like flashes come through or damage away, that's what he could try and follow up. But Ala really wants this kill, tries to go and isn't able to connect the Q. So it just means he is, you know, some free money from a nice ATM for the side of BLG.
This wake up for BLG though, right? Like objective focus. They've gotten both dragons. They've gotten a rift hero. They've gotten.
おはようございます。
Denied a lot of the playmaking from LNG. Every time we've seen them be aggressive, it's LNG being way too aggressive, and BLG are right there, holding out their hands, waiting for the gold to drop it. And it's actually been an incredible wake up for BLG. But again, biggest focus for them is they do have strong starts.The slow finish that gets them. It's the catch out in the mid to late game that always gets them. And you see some of the potential for catch out on LNG's squad right now.
I gotta say, though, I feel like one of the reasons why LNG are overforcing so hard is when you're committing with some of these ults or some of these roams, the one we saw earlier, even just now in mid lane, right? Things like Paranoia and Cyclone. LNG winning the game or finding advantages is pretty much solely based
on
finding the dives with
the.
Don't get the kill at first. I feel like they feel pressured to double down, or it's like, hey, we just
wait. Wave clear の早い明かりは。あかんのとちゃう。
We need something off of this. And sadly for them, that feeling is pushing them even further into the hole.
Yeah, it is. And for the first time, it feels like in this series, BLG actually have a little bit of advantage. Not much, but it's something. And I think you're looking at the setup for them in terms of that late game that's looking a lot better than the other games we've had, right? This is a definitely a different draft.
Yeah, but ultimately, they're not such a champion. ナーが強いときはナーがトップレーンを支配するんです。もうそういうチャンピオン性能してるんで。
You know, the assumed counter jungling they think can come through from the side of Tarzan and just make sure their team is getting that gold. So,
どのマッチアップにも勝ってたしね。
Like able to cover both sides of the map well. LNG, I think, would really like to play aggressive around the spot lane. It's just so hard when you constantly have to be in fear of that hostile takeover coming and locking you down, which is why LNG are leaning so heavily around mid for so long.
Yeah, and it just hasn't given them any big avenues just yet. I think you're still looking at the potential burst of Light and Lumao. But again, last time we saw this competition for LNG, it was the Aphelios for them. Is that late game insurance policy? The team fight
the guy's coming through!
But you're talking about that proactivity. Let's see if they can actually get Doggo.
やっぱ Renata が強いな。
A little bit late. Now he's just dead here potentially. Lumao can't really save him, doesn't have the tidal wave. Ben flashes the bubble. Ale has to pop the slicing maelstrom. Does he still go down? The counter strike nicely done. Ben doesn't get the kill onto him. And LNG get out.
LNG though, try to find the dive. We were just hitting on how hard it's going to be into the Moonlight Vigil, into the hostile takeover. They don't manage to find anything. And for BLG, that's a win. When we've hit on the scaling able to come through for their side, they're feeling great. Even getting some deep vision down in the enemy jungle to spot out where Tarzan will be and instantly pivoting into dropping the Herald. Look where Doggo is on the minimap. They're going to be able to make a multi-man push. Oh, and it looks like Weiwei and Icon even going to wait on the other side of the turret and potentially pick people off in transition.
They can do so. Perfect fusion there. Crescent Guard is there. They already get the bait out as LNG committed to the tower. And now Light gets pushed out here.
Oh,
nice
bubble
as well. Tarzan does not survive for very long, though. Icon, he wants it. He's feeling confident here. And this is the first time it's felt like BLG have a firm advantage.
We can see when BLG have time. Kind of overforcing some of these plays, overforcing their hand, and have lanes that can more easily hold up. Not a Neela, a Mumu down in that bot side, just getting punished so hard that they can get through the mid game and they can have some of these smarter decisions coming through. That's one thing that surprised me when I was going back watching. Oh, maybe watching Bin go in. No, watching BLG VODs is not a lot of LTL teams like to cross map, but BLG are one of these teams who I think make smarter decisions when games are firmly in their control. We will see here though. They're making this beautiful setup, waiting on the opposite side of the turret. A lot of big damage able to come out on Tarzan from Doggo and Crisp. And then, sadly for
Barely.
Icon, just missing on that shuriken to be able to go through and find another one.
That was actually so, so close. But if BLG want to keep the pedal here, they do have a dragon spawning about 25 seconds. They have Doggo and Crisp in mid lane pushing it out. There's no mid lane tower to defend for LNG, so the pressure should be there for this setup for BLG.
いや、これ減ったね、確かに。
Continuing to get 100% objective focus.
Ooh. All I know, Mazel, is coming out from last game. We're talking about how hard the mental edge is. Oh, it's so hard to come back from O2. Fake news. We don't know anything because BLG.
まあ、倍がメタに上がったのが大きいんじゃない。
Yeah, it just feels like the comp fits their mental right now. Fits their playstyle. It's working
fits
out
their
so
mental.
Well. Yeah, because they're playing.
てか、ば、ビエゴが減った一番の要因は、ボットレーンの主導権取るために、エンチャンターサポートが増えたから、ジャングラーにある程度エンゲージ要素が欲しいってなってんですよ。死んじゃうのバフは実際いいもんだっつって、パッチノートを読んだときに俺確か言ってた気がする。14回言ってたんだっけ？出てくるよっていう話は俺した気がする。死んじゃうのバフは。13だったかな？バフ受けた
の。solely dictated by BLG. I feel like LNG may be looking at a pick towards sides,
意味か。で、ADC メタになったから、ジャオがバフされたら出てきて
る。
ビエゴはあと 1-2 で若干ナーフされました。あの、一番あと大きな理由は、ビエゴのあの E で隠れて、ダブル打って E 打ったら、速攻ステルスになるっつうのがなくなったから、それも大きな要因だね。今までは先手をイージーで取れて、エリアをビエゴの E でエリアを取れるってまあ強みだったけど、エリア取りがちょっと難しくなってエンチャンターサポートがネタになって、ビエゴ運用ちょっと難しいねってなってる。あとは何だろうね。ドラフトがちょっと難しい。今の状態でビエゴを取ると。やっぱウーコンがね、ドラフトしやすいっすよ。全部できるから、ウーコン。ジャングル回れて、ブリンク持ってて、壁越えできるジャングラー。で、エンゲージできて、ディバインできたら 1v1 強く。アーマー低減あって、今の ADC メタに最強の環境。ターザンがさ、ずっといいんだよな。まあでもマウンテンソウルエンドか。懸念が入る位置分かってるから怖くないんだよ。
BLG try to set up here, but LNG just feel very confident and try to move in position, in pole position of this dragon. As it does reset, Icon's going over the wall. The flank, the different pincer maneuvers from BLG could make a difference here. UMB not having anything here. Ben getting a little bit lower. Icon waiting, buying time, not deciding to go in just yet until LNG have committed. But they've already committed onto Ben. Ben counter-strikes off of it. Icon now has the pixel brush on the backside. LNG need to be very, very careful. But Ben is leaving. Moonlight Vigil comes out. Lumel almost goes down to the Chakrams. It's all a little shuriken flip from Icon makes the difference here. On to Lumel, he's got him. The slicing maelstrom shuts down Icon. The light very, very low. Ben gets the easy clap down kill, and BLG with the reset on the fight with Doggo's big.
お互いポジションの有利なポジションの奪い合い。
Wayway's down. The dragon 3,000 health, and BLG they don't have a smite.
Okay, but. Are LNG actually going to go for it? They need to. Tarzan.
Doonby handshook. Ben is full health on the side here. Doonby is going in. He's flashing. He's got the spell shield. It's not enough. Tarzan focusing on Chris. Chris not going to go down. The bailout just in time. And Ben shuts down the kill. Dragon soul to BLG.
And BLG are going to be so strong after this point. How much this does for them when we hit on LNG's comp.
懸念が裏から入るのか、明かりが裏から入るのかの駆け引きで、ビンが耐えちゃった。
BLG without indecisive they were being in the moment. I feel like they should have just brought in Icon as soon as LNG committed there, but they wait for Doggo to gale force in throughout the Moonlight Vigil. Instantly, Lumao's low, and Icon's like, okay, this is my time. We lock one member down. We have the TP able to come through from Ben.And he finds the kill. He does go down, but he also makes them waste the Slicing Maelstrom. So right there, that is not possible for LNG to win the team fight anymore. Light gone, no cannon ulti. But I love on the minimap, you can see the whole time, Tarzan was running towards Weiwei and pinging like, hey, let's take this guy down. At least we can stall a bit of their momentum. They did it, but sadly, Dragon still over to BLG.
That extra shielding, those extra resists, so crucial for BLG at this point. And...Picks are going to be fewer and far between, more far between at least for LNG. I just wonder, like,
やっぱ涙積んだ分だけノックが来るいいね。1ゲーム目だとね、ゲーム1はセカンドで明かりをバンしてたんです。このゲームは明かりバンしなかったのが、やっぱそういうことなんだ。いい、ノクターンのいいよ、明かりがいいで消せるから。別視されても怖くないしね、アカリさん。
あ、うん、
なるほど。
わ
あ、あれうまい。だが、アレさん、いけんのか。おお、駆け引きで勝った。うめえな、2回駆け引きで勝ったぞ、あのあれ。
I mean, the flash came out from Allah, right? He didn't just outright miss. The dodge did come through, but it sets up the Baron for BLG. And LNG just not even to look for. You can see Doonby now already coming down towards the bot side. I was curious if they'd look to TP in, because one of the benefits about, you know, having two soldiers with TP is you can look to make that play, TP them both up to the Baron, and then win a fight with numbers advantage. But with no Slicing Maelstrom, with no Paranoia, really not having a lot left in the tank to where LNG, I feel like, would be...in a good place to actually win that fight.
Yeah, LNG do find themselves a bounty, at least. Gold is definitely in BLG's favor. We'll see Icon trying to make the outplays here.
Goes in with the ulti, misses the initial E to come through. Again, another 5-point strike.
Yeah, これ3回駆け引きで勝ってる。
Go for the flash into the E. No, actually,
yeah,
Allah
did flash
it. He did just miss it. I was right the first time. I thought in my mind, there's no way he just missed that. There's no way. He must have flashed. I see a flash is down.
最初のプロトベルトの駆け引きと、途中のフラッシュの駆け引きと、最後の E の駆け引き。3回とも勝ったんだ。
But at this point, right, BLG are just flexing their muscles a bit with this Baron buff. They have a lot of time, a lot of siege potential for themselves. But, you know, I'm looking at some completions coming up here. Three items right on the cusp for both these ADCs. And for me as well, like, looking at Tarzan, he went with the GA second item, right? They know that they're in a deficit. They know that they need to buy time in a lot of these fights.
I actually don't know how much more that does for you, because, I mean, let's say you die and go down after you guys engage. Paranoia's already down. Cyclone's already down. Slicing Maelstrom's already down. Now what do you do in this fight against an Aphelios, against an Akali and a Jax that can just so, like, keep consistently putting up these big damage?
Ukon.
On the flank is all.
He finds again. We said one flank could make the difference. They're on the back line. The bubble hits. The bailout there. Light trying to buy time against Wei. Light survives. He dies right afterwards, though. Icon is making the difference in the fight. Crisp and Bin, they're all here, but Icon is trying to make his name. No, it's Bin that comes through clutch. And Tarzan, he tried to make the big brain engage, but they're so far behind, it's almost impossible.
That was the best they could hope for. They had the flank. Everyone's able to get in. The AD carry goes down. But BLG have multiple threats that you have to worry about. They're just going to keep going with their Baron pushes as well. Icon and Crisp in mid. You can see Bin pushing that top lane as well. They're just going to keep growing this lead. 10 seconds on light, so they're going to be a little bit...
Mountain だけは今ので決まってるんですけどね。
They're going to be happy with the turrets that they've gotten.
Yeah, and I mean, Doggo does go down, but, you know, he's not the one with a lot of gold on the team. And I think they, you know, realize that BLG right now are like a Hydra. You cut one head off, two more spawn, and it's been an icon.
We'll see here as well. Tarzan coming in from one angle, like tidal wave there. Paranoia in. They get on top of the Aphelios to take him down. But you look on the back line. Wei Wei's not letting Light get in. And pretty much...
いや、レナータあかんわ。レナータがダメだ、やっぱ。このチャンピオン OP だ。
That's when the fight really comes online from BLG. So LNG seriously got the best they could have hoped for.
Yep.
And it still wasn't able to work.
And they're staring down the barrel of almost the 10,000 gold. I guess 8,000 at this point. Skipping a nice little bubble under Finn. The red buff actually goes over to Tarzan. So still the aggression for BLG. But we have Elder coming up in 20 seconds. We'll see if BLG can position themselves correctly around this pit and set up for the objective.
So both AD carries now having their Infinity Edge online, so will be, you know, starting to hit at that huge spike. Doombi also picked up a GA of his own, so hoping that, hey, even if I do have to engage and go down, even if
いやもうナフの仕様がないね、でもね、これ以上。
Maybe enough, those few extra autos, those few extra seconds could be the difference maker if they are able to take down.
They aren't in position here. They don't have, they really can't. I mean, they're going to push out mid lane.
もうこれ以上ナフすんだったらもうデフォルトの移動速度落とすしかない。
Doombi trying to catch Bin out inside, but he's just buying time, right? Here comes BLG now as well to collapse onto the mispositioning of Doombi. And the bubble actually landing on
E のスロー効果消すとかね。これぐらいしかない。
Doombi has TP, so it looks like he's going to go for the back. He's going to TP in, but no, he's going to go around. Bin has the same play available. And they're just doing.
まあ、でも、あの、相手の構成に依存するから、出なったって結局は。まあ、そこはいい点だけどね。フレッシュって敵の構成に依存しなかったじゃないですか。レナータの R は敵の構成に依存して強さが変わるから、まあ、そこはマジでなんか許してあげようみたいな。
They're not even looking at the dragon at this point. They want to finish off the kills, and they will try to find it in the end. Doombi is in some trouble. He has the GA, but it's Lumao that goes down first, and this is BLG responding to the double haymaker that LNG put down in this best of five, and they are doing so lively.
And I love that Doggo's the one to follow it through with the Gale Force in and bring BLG back in this series. Breathe some life into them, and then now, Mazel, we might get something competitive.
We actually get a series. What is it that casters like to have on their hands, Lyric?
でも BLG すごいのがさ、ノクターン、ウーコン、懸念の構成見て、3ゲーム目までにカウンター構成準備できてるっていうのがすごいです。